Now that we have discussed the life cycle of this device and have an understanding of the security strategy for the entire information assets, let's look at why we need to manage information assets or information security asset management. The most important logic here is actually to maintain ownership. As we just mentioned, the owner has control over the data. They should have absolute control. Our protection of information assets is actually for the purpose of maintaining the rights and interests of the owner. Here is the thing, there are two aspects. On the one hand, we have to ensure that the data itself is safe and reliable. On the other hand, we also need to ensure or try to enhance the value of the data. Both are very important. If a piece of data itself, it's just a piece of data, it doesn't reflect the value of the data, then the management of this data is actually in vain. Another point is that we have to ensure that it is controllable or safe during the process of data processing or use. If there is a leak or the data is distorted, then our use or operation of the data is meaningless and valueless. So the whole data management is a long-term data strategy, and our security is safe and reliable, which is actually part of the whole data strategy. If you can take another course called DAMA, D-A-M-A, then DAMA is specifically about the entire governance framework of data, and data security management is just a module of their data governance framework. So our security of information assets also needs to be in line with the overall data strategy. From the perspective of data strategy, one aspect is security. What else for data use? From the perspective of management, it is called responsibility or duty. This is called RAM, a concept of management. You don't have to remember, it is what we call the responsibility assignment matrix. So who uses the data? Who maintains the data? Who owns the data? Who conducts project audits for data security? All need to have division of labor. In modern data quality and data management, there is another very important requirement for data quality called data documentation. What does this documentation refer to? A popular term now is metadata. The concept of metadata itself is a very important term in data governance, but it is also important in our data security. This metadata actually describes the attributes of the data. It's not the data itself. For example, the file name we give to a certain file, or based on relational databases, our definition of this data column. For example, like gender, name, student number, these all belong to metadata. So metadata is not the data itself. It is created to better capture or describe data, capture data relationships and create data. This data is also very important from a security perspective, because metadata can enable the data mining. If we are blind to metadata and use it without any method, then it may be found that data may leak, data privacy or misuse of data. So now the use of metadata also needs to be controlled or managed accordingly. This is explicitly required in the data security law promulgated by our country in 2021. In addition to what we just mentioned, management, including division of labor, including the description of metadata, there is also continuous data auditing. That is, in the entire process of data use or governance, can we ensure that one is high quality data? That is, can the security of the data be guaranteed? And another aspect is the value of the data. For example, we may reduce the value of data when backing up or when operating on data, damage the data. This would be more loss than gain. So the whole data audit is also necessary in the process of data use. It's a must do thing. Actually, it reduces the risk of data. So we just talked about the whole process of data operation. Here we mentioned a very important concept at the beginning, that is the data policy. The data policy is different from the data security policy. So the data policy, it is a guiding framework document for data management. We can understand it as how to maximize the value of data, that is to allow data to provide the maximum value. This is the data policy. Actually, the data policy, it's more about the business level, and security is part of the data policy. We just discussed here, that includes who is the owner in the data policy. Must be clearly written. Another one is compliance. our use of data must meet the requirements of laws and regulations, including a part of the cost of processing and protecting data, and the value of the data assets themselves. We need to balance. If the cost of using or protecting data exceeds the value of the data itself, it would also be more loss than gain. Including in 2021, our country also promulgated a personal information protection law. Here are some requirements for the use of personal data, such as the use of privacy or management.